So hopefully you've seen binary before. But so here's a refresher. So binary encoding is really just base 2. So whereas we're used to working with 10 digits in base 10, so 0 up through 9, base 2 only has two digits, 0 and 1. And so the ith bit represents the value 2 to the I. And bits are typically written from the most significant to the least significant. So for instance, the leftmost bit is the highest power of 2. And then the next bit is the next lowest power of 2, and so forth. So it's worth looking at pondering this slide for a bit, so maybe pausing the video and thinking about this a little bit. So just to highlight one or two of these examples, so 5 can be written in binary as 0101, or you know, we don't need this leading 0, right? So this could just be 101. And there are a couple of different ways to think about this. So you could think about 5 as being 4 plus 1, right? So it is 1 times 2 to the second power, so that's the 4, plus 1 times 2 to the 0th power, which is the 1, so that's the 4 plus 1. And so this digit, this power of 2 is not present, right? There are no 2 to the firsts or 2 once you've subtracted 4 from 5, and so there's going to be a 0 in that place in the encoding. So these are some other examples, so it's worth looking through these to convince yourself that all these are correct and to start seeing the patterns of how it works. In order to convert values back and forth between these systems, basically when you're converting from binary to decimal, you just add up all the powers of 2. So you look at the binary number, so for instance here you'd look at this number here, and then you'd kind of, I work from right to left because I find it easier to work that way. So this is a 1, right? So we have a 1, we have a 2, so we can add those together, we get 3. We don't have a 4, but we do have an 8, and so we would take, you know, 8 plus the 3 that we had before and add it together, and you get 11. Going the other direction can be a little bit more difficult. You kind of have to find the highest power of 2 in your number and then subtract to find the remainder. So for instance, to convert 15 to binary, we would find the highest power of 2, which is 8, right? So 16 is the next power of 2 after 8, and we don't have 16 to work with, so we have to use the next lowest power. So we'll take 15, we subtract 8, that gives us 7. We find the highest power of 2 that we can subtract, which is 4, and then we just keep continuing this until we get to 0. And in this case, we're going to have 1 of each power of 2. And this is kind of interesting because that adds up to the number that is 1 less than the next power of 2, right? Which, if you think about it a little bit, is what you should expect here. There is actually a method that some people find a bit simpler to convert from decimal to binary. And so if this is helpful to you, then I would recommend doing this. If this does not seem to be as easy to you as the other method, then you don't need to worry about it. So it's generally, it deals with remainders. So you take the number that you're trying to convert to binary and you just repeatedly divide by 0. And every time you divide by 0, you use an integer arithmetic, and so you're always going to have either 0 or 1 as the remainder, and you just keep track of those remainders. Once you have all the remainders, you read them off in reverse order, and that gets you your binary encoding. So, for instance, if we're trying to convert 11 to binary, we'd start with 11, we'd divide by 2, that gets us, well, this is an odd number, right? So we subtract the 1 as the remainder, we get 10 divided by 2 is 5, so 11 divided by 2 in integer modulus arithmetic is going to be 5 remainder 1. We divide 5 by 2, we get 2 remainder 1. 2 divided by 2 is 1 remainder 0. And then 1 divided by 2 is going to be 0 remainder 1. So then we take these bits and we just read them in reverse order. So we start at the bottom, we go to the top, and that is our binary equivalent. And if we look at this, we can test this and find that this actually works, because this is an 8 plus 2, which is 10, plus 1, which is 11. So take a minute here and pause the video and see if you can convert the decimal number 25 to binary using either of the methods shown, although I'm going to show the solution using the remainder method that we just talked about. So again, pause the video and see if you can work this out yourself. Okay, so 25 is the original number. We'll divide by 2, so this is an odd number, so we subtract 1 as the remainder. We have 24 left over. divide 24 by 2, we get 12. So 25 divided by 2 is going to be 12, remainder 1. 12 is even, so that just goes down to 6, remainder 0. 6 divided by 2 is 3, remainder 0. Now we're back to an odd number, which means that we'll have a remainder. And 3 divided by 2 is 1, remainder 1. 1 divided by 2 is 0, remainder 1. And now we're done. We read the bits off in reverse order. We get 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, which again we can test by adding them up as powers of 2. So we have, it might be easier to do this sort of from right to left, from least significant to most significant. So we have 1 plus no 2s, no 4s, an 8. So 1 plus 8 is 9. Plus 16 is 25.